Could there be life elsewhere in the universe? Well, if you want to answer that question, you first have to understand how and where water is formed and how much there is, because water is one of the key ingredients for life as we know it. And what we have learned over the past decades through our observations, through our models, through our laboratory experiments, is that water is formed already on those tiny little dust grains in those dark clouds, even before the collapse of that cloud, to form a new star like our Sun and then a planetary system. Astrochemistry is the formation, destruction, excitation of molecules in different astronomical environments. But it is actually so much more than that, because we can use molecules also as a probe of physical conditions, as a measure of the temperature and the density. Also, the molecules themselves affect the structure and the evolution of clouds by being the main coolants of the gas. And then, indeed, the whole story about the origin of stars and planets. The space between the stars is not empty, but it's filled with a very, very dilute gas, only about 1 atom per cubic centimeter. That is much more empty than anything we can make on Earth in terms of an ultra-high vacuum. But that makes interstellar space also such a fantastic chemical laboratory, because we can study chemical processes under conditions that are very different from those that we normally encounter here on Earth. For millions of years, these clouds are stable, but then a small part of them can start to collapse under its own weight. That's also what happened with our own Sun. It basically originated from a cloud like this. And they are so dark because they contain tiny little dust particles, a little bit like the sand grains that you have on the beach, but then about 1,000 times smaller. And the dust grains are very important because they absorb and scatter the light, so they protect the molecules inside the clouds, but also because they play a role in making new molecules, especially water and organic molecules. To me, it's one continuing story. We started from the large scales of the clouds, then we collapsed the clouds to form protostars and the protoplanetary disks. Now with ALMA, we are able to zoom in into those disks and see actually the regions where likely at this very moment giant planets are forming. My dream for the next decade is to zoom in even further, to go very close to the mother star where the terrestrial planets are likely forming, planets like our own Earth, and to study the chemical composition there. And that will actually be possible with the launch of the James Webb Space Telescope and also the extremely large telescopes that are built on the ground. They have the ability to zoom in onto that inner region.